and I'm rocking out with Chitown.
Chitown
Urban Radio,
Urban Radio.
Hey guys, this is Attila, ATTXLA, because X marks the spot all day, every day. And you are watching or listening to, depending on what you're doing, Chitown Urban Radio. Thank you.
You're jamming to Chitown Urban Radio.
As in this game, this modeling game, this entertainment game, let's just say that. How do you protect yourself from the stalkers and the people who are just, they're crazy?
Well, I don't post much of, like, I may post a video where I'm at here, but they don't know the location.
Yeah.
So I don't really put locations of where I'm at. But if I'm out at, like, a lounge or something like that, I'll put the check-in, who I'm with as a friend. Mm-hmm. But other than that, I don't tell people where I live. I don't tell people any small detail that can give them a hint where I'm at the moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
I have maybe.
And I'm not on the internet. I don't do.
You don't do the internet that much.
I do to post like you know, promoting or you know, shout out to someone or things like that. You know, of that nature, but not necessarily my location.
Yeah. and for me, it's hard because like if I'm DJing somewhere, I want people to come there. So it's like. I had, she's not a stalker, but my baby mama came up to her while I was working at.
Okay.
And I was DJing at a club, and she threatened to suit the club up and stuff. So.
What? Yeah. For real?
It's crazy, man.
You made her mad?
I must have did something.
No, so. But it's different for as a DJ. You want people to come and support you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So like, on one page, do you have, like, the... I guess I would say like the studio that you're at, but not like the exact part of the studio. Like maybe I would say like the place next door to the studio, but then change the name.
If I'm like at a fashion show or something like that, I'll tell people, hey, I'm here, you know. But like filming at CineSpace Film Studio, that's different. There's a lot of people, security guards there and such. But
yeah.
I mean, other than that, I don't really tell people where I'm at. Unless it's my friend. Snapchat? I'm not really on Snapchat like that.
See, yeah. It's not just me. I just got back
home. I don't even know how to work Snapchat.
No. People will send me videos or something, what they're doing, and I'll be like, hey, okay. I posted before I came here on Snapchat because I just got new followers, so.
That's good.
Yeah.
It's always nice to have followers.
Yeah.
It's an interesting concept. It is very interesting.
Especially if you got something going for yourself, it helps a lot.
Yeah, it is.
With your networking and things like that. Yeah, silent supporters, you're right.
So what's the plan for the summertime? The springtime is, it doesn't seem like springtime, but it's almost here.
Is it snowing? No, it stopped snowing.
Just a little wind.
So, what are your plans for the summertime? Any projects, anything coming up?
Yes, a couple films. What else? I plan to do some traveling. What else? Family. My sister's having a baby soon. Okay. Hey, Danisha, my sister. I want to be there for her when she has the child. And what else? Riding my bicycle. I love being outside.
What kind of bike you get?
I have a Giant.
Okay.
It's an old school.
For like the thick wheels or the skinny wheels?
Skinny wheel. It's a classic old school bike with a leather seat and handle.
With the curb?
Curb handle?
Yeah.
Every time I went to this spot near Montrose Urban Park and near Montrose Beach, I would get my tires filled with air. And the guy there, every time I see him, for him to put air in my tires, he always tried to buy my bike for like $700 or something like that. Like, he really likes my bicycle. I'm like, no, you can't have this.
You're gonna sell it to him in a few years when it's more vintage. Like,
yeah.
Maybe.
But I love it. I love bicycling. I like being outdoors.
Yeah, yeah.
I do want to reach LA sometime this summer.
Okay.
Stay for a little bit. I have some friends who live out there.
Okay.
So,
are you a sidewalk biker or are you an in the street biker?
I'm in the streets. I don't like sidewalk bikers. Although I've done that once because I went down on a one way street. And
do they push you off whenever like they're on the sidewalk and they pass you by?
Yeah, because like, you half the time I don't even see them. I don't know about anyone else, but I almost get hit by one all the time.
Exactly.
And those are mostly the divvy bikers. They don't know how to ride bikes.
Yeah.
That's a whole different ball game I gotta learn about.
Yeah, divvy bikers suck.
I had a BMX when I was little. I had a BMX, but that's about it. I didn't really get into biking. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I'll just really stick to my music and everything. So, who you jamming to nowadays? Who you jamming to?
Always Kendrick Lamar, J. Cole. What's his name? Lil Durk. I like some of his songs.
You like that?
I just heard about him.
Okay.
Who else? I still listen to some jazz. I love jazz music. Calms me down. I get through my day. I like calm music that keeps me elevated and, you know, ease my mind.
You don't like that raindrop top.
Raindrop. Yeah, I'll listen to that to get hype, you know, going out with friends.
What about female?
I actually just heard that song not too long ago, Raindrop Drop Top. Raindrops drop top.
Okay, what about female MCs? Who are you listening to?
Female MCs,
artist, pop artist, jazz, classical, country, jazz.
Okay, I'm thinking like rap and such.
No, whatever.
I love Blossom Dairy. She's a jazz musician.
Blossom Dairy.
Yes. Okay. Emily King. She has a beautiful voice. Who else? I still listen to Leah, Shanti, old music. I'm more to, you know, 90s, early
2000s. I just said that earlier.
I like that, though. See, I grew up on, like, 90s, early 2000 music, the Ja Rule.
Yeah, Ja Rule.
And, what's that? What's the dude's
what's
name?
What's my name?
Old 50, old Kanye.
Kanye, yeah.
Common. What's that girl name? Tamia.
I'm so in. No, not that.
No,
so into you. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, that is it. No, never mind. Yeah. So I liked how music was back then. It gave me a message more than, you know, the raindrop drop top stuff. Mm-hmm. The Migos. It's like, I don't know, man.
Don't get me wrong. It's fun to hype up to that, but I just like the old.
You need something to keep you calm younger. Throughout the day and just
I don't know.
I think
like you said with communication, I guess that instantly gets you out of the friend zone. You got to like be bold enough to put yourself out there, I guess. Kind of, you got to know how to present it to her appropriately so you're not really shot down depending on how she is.
If you know her and you guys been friends for a while and you knows her likes and dislikes, I think that may help you.
Okay.
You know, I think that may help you.
But if you look at a person just that way, if you look at Joe just that way
as a friend,
how do you alter that? How do you go about like, okay, I don't see you anything other than that?
What? He's gonna have to take it, you know, one way or another.
I guess so. You're going to have to take that leap of faith.
I don't know many friends who end up with a guy who likes them very much.
Unfortunately.
But if, as the male, I feel like, or as the woman, I feel like it's best to, you know, tell them how you feel. But I don't like hurting people's feelings. So you're either going to have to deal with it, but I don't want anything to be awkward, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
To me, it may end up being awkward if he tells me that.
Mm.
Yeah.
A little bit. And y'all might not be able to chill like that anymore.
Maybe.
Or it can get even awkwarder and you can give it a try. Like, I've did this before. You can give it a try and then you can feel that connection with that person, but you can still just not want to hurt them because, you know, honestly and truly, like, at the end of the day, like, this is fun, but no, you're not who I, like, honestly and truly want to be with. You want that we kind of want that unknown excitement of getting to know somebody. So when someone knows you too well, you have to dig deeper.
I like
a lot
that.
Of people don't.
I like that. You want to get to know, because if you know somebody, they kind of know your everything about you already, and it's kind of like you want to not start fresh, but you know, you just. Sometimes you just don't want to go in knowing a lot of people. That's just, ain't nothing wrong with that.
I think friendships create routines, and in relationships, routines is what gets boring.
Yeah.
So that would be an interesting barrier to try to cross if y'all don't have that physical connection, honestly.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. The call in number 312-985-7834. If you got a suggestion, call in, man. We'd love to hear your inputs. 312-985-7834. Call in. So
call people.
So I don't want
to. How to get out of the friend zone?
I don't want to mess up your name. Please don't be mad at me. I went to junior high school, so I went to Cook County. How do you pronounce your name?
Deandrea.
Okay,
yes.
That's a mouthful. I ain't gonna lie.
Back at home, people call me Dee Dee.
Dee Dee.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dee Dee, like from Dexter's Laboratory.
Do you like that?
I did, but when I moved here, I made sure everyone called me Deandrea.
Where are you originally from?
To keep it professional. People know me by my real name.
Where are you originally from, if people wasn't listening before?
Carmel, Indiana.
Indiana, okay. Yes. That's what it is. Carmel. How far is that from the city?
From here, it's a three-hour ride.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not bad.
So, whenever I travel home, I usually take the Greyhound or Megabus.
Okay.
There's no use of flying.
No. Not to Indiana.
No.
But so as you know, you're doing the modeling and you're a trying actress.
Mm-hmm.
What are some roles that you would like to be a part of?
I love action movies, and I like green screen work and digital effects.
Okay.
So something fantasy, something like Avatar, you know, the blue people, Avatar.
Like the sci-fi.
Yes.
Sci-fi, yeah, types. I would love to land a role in a movie like that.
Okay.
Zoe Zandala, she's one of my favorite actresses, and I love all the roles she's played, like in Chronicles of Riddick as a queen. Like, I want to play roles like her.
Okay. Off top, what is your top three favorite movies?
My top three, I like Meet the Fockers, Boys in the Hood, and Black Hawk Down.
Okay.
I haven't seen that last one. I have to see that.
Black Hawk Down.
Did you see Get Out?
I did.
What was last weekend. What were your thoughts on it?
My thought, despite of everyone talking about it.
Be honest. Say how you
They gave me a mindset and gave me a clue how the movie is going to be. So when I watched it, I enjoyed it, but at the same time, I was pinpointing symbols and stuff like that. And I'm whispering, you know, to my friend, like, so this is what this means. Like, I think she's in on it, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The girlfriend. So throughout the whole movie, I'm just dictating what's going to happen. And
do you think that you're going to rewatch it a second time?
I can see myself watching it down the road, yes.
Okay.
Yes. But if someone were to ask me to go see it with them now,
no.
I would.
Oh, you
would? Okay. I would.
Okay. You know, because I do video editing, and to me, it's a gift and a curse. Because when I watch movies, it's like, man, why the hell he didn't do that? Well, why? You know, because I can't watch a movie as a perspective as a
consumer.
You know what I'm saying? And it bothers me sometimes.
Yeah, working behind the scenes on. Like shows, like I've done extra work on Empire, Chicago Med, and some shows here filmed in Chicago. Like watching how things work behind the screen, how they cheat things, and how you know, they take breaks in between and setting up stuff. Whenever I watch movies now, I'm always thinking how the production is working.
Yeah.
So and I like watching the backgrounds too.
Okay, that's what it is.
In the meantime, if someone wants you to be in one of their projects, they want you to be in their fashion show, they want you to be in one of their videos, how do you suggest they reach out to you?
Reach out to me? You can send me an email at actress.deandrea@gmail.com.
Okay. Do you have a what's that website that they have for actresses?
Like backstage?
Not backstage.
I was talking about, I was telling him about Casting 360, excuse me.
Oh, Casting 360? I don't have an account with
them. They have like acting lessons on there too, but I've never like taken them.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Like suggestions for classes to attend?
Like they have like videos that you can watch, but I don't know.
Oh, okay.
I'd rather be in like the scene with all the people.
I took classes at Actors Studio that's on Elston and Ashland for a good year, and my coach, Mr. Hardaway, shout out, he's amazing. He's lived in London, he's taken classes himself and studied the art of acting and literature and such, and he has a lot of experience, and he taught me pretty well. And I should be seeing him soon. But you should. I would suggest you take classes. It's another way to help you get out of your comfort zone. Believe me. They have
exercises.
Like, think about it. You're going there to learn, not to be judged by other people. Mm-hmm. So that's how I looked at it when I went to the class. And there's an exercise that had you crying, you know, just to get you out of your head while trying to perform, you know, your character. There's a lot to learn.
Modeling.
Look into that.
Modeling wise, who would you like to work with?
I would like to work.
One of my followers said Empire. That's where I've seen her.
Who is it?
His name is Big Body Fiji.
Big Body.
I don't know that Instagram name, but if I see his face,
I'll show you a picture.
I'll recognize him. Who would I like to work with? I would like to work with a lot of people. Gucci's always been one of my top, you know, brands. I like Tommy Hilfiger, I'm not going to lie. I like their marketing brand and how clean their images are. Who else? I don't know.
What about Old Navy?
Old Navy? I don't know. I never thought about Old Navy.
They
I like JCP, okay. JCPenney commercials. I also want to do voiceover too.
Okay.
I have experienced that of like a month ago with a feature film that I was filming for. I did some voiceover for them, and I thought that was pretty much fun.
Okay.
So,
you have a great conversation. You do everything.
But, I guess, okay, well, let me ask you this then. Modeling-wise, photographers, who are you looking to work with?
I have a list somewhere. I don't remember all their names.
Name a few that you can remember.
Nigel Barker is one of my favorites because I, you know, America's Next Top Model. I think he's amazing. There's another person on Instagram. He goes by, Lone Photography. He's based in LA.
Okay.
His work is really gorgeous. He captured, you know, black females and their beauty, and his work is awesome. Who else? I think his name is Carlton something. He's here in Chicago. A Chicago photographer.
Okay. What about a Nick Skills or somebody?
Who?
Nick Skills.
Nick Skills? I've heard of him. He does
a lot of eye candy.
Eye candy, yeah.
Okay.
I try to stay.
You stay away from that?
Yeah. But I wouldn't mind if we come up with a certain concept together.
Okay.
You know.
Okay.
That, you know.
that could really
that fits with my look and
I like how you're very cautious about it. Has to make sense towards your brand.
It does.
If it doesn't make sense towards your brand, then what am I doing it for? You know what I'm saying? And people have to look at it as a business.
Yes.
You know, some people, I just want to get on the show just to get on the show. Well,
you have to have a reason, a purpose behind whatever it is you're doing.
Exactly.
Or want to do.
So what drives you to do what you do?
What drives me when, like, someone approached me, or
what drives you in general to wake up every day and be like,
well,
I'm here, world.
I'm here. No, I always strive for something better. Like if I didn't finish something on my to-do list the day before, it's on my brain before I go to bed. I try to do that every night. If I constantly repeat, D, don't forget to do this, don't forget to talk to this person or message this person, and I wake up and that's what's on my brain, and I'm like, I have to keep moving forward. Like, I have to, in order to be where, you know, relax somewhere on a beach like 30 years from now, mm-hmm. that's what drives me, you know, every morning to, you know, become this person that I want to become. And it's like, I can't waste any time. That's how it feels like. Because if I waste time, it's like, why am I living today? You know what I'm saying? Like, it makes no sense to me. I have to be motivated, keep myself motivated, and I have to do something all the time.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I feel like I missed out on something. So I'm up, laptop, emailing, answering people back, looking for, you know, agencies, looking for someone who needs this and that, you know, people who'd be like, hey, can you read the script for me, tell me if you want, like, I need to do it, you know. You can't move forward if you're still stuck, you know.
No, you really can't.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this, how important, and I ask people this all the time, how important is to invest into your brand?
I feel like you can, there's no way skipping around investing into something, at mm-hmm. least something. Whether it's great photography work, whether it's making your own website, whether it's, you know, getting your hair done to, you know, look a part, or, you know, I think it's important. Unless you have it all already, you know what I'm saying, then it's mm-hmm. easy for you. But if you don't, you need to put that money aside and do, you know, pay for whatever it is you need to move forward with, you know.
What are some tips, I'm sorry, that you would give someone who would be starting off branding themselves, even if it's on